Well, there we are. I guess we're live. That's awesome. You know, when you work out of your house and you get really excited about something, you really don't have a lot of people to tell about. So I thought, well, I'll go live, share a little about my new book because it's done. It's at the designer. I told my office mate, Buddy Lee, but he is not much of a conversationalist. Here's the cover. This is going to come out. It's Get Past the Crap, Lead Yourself First, Bounce Back, Get Shit Done. And you know, this is my fifth book, and I like all my books, but most of them are blog compilation books. I write a lot of content. I'm really good at 1,000 words or less, putting together a nice little package story, things to fix, you know, fix the problem, how to wrap it up at the end, and that's what I do really, really well. So this one is a little bit different because I actually hired a book coach to help me, you know, through the whole process. If you're looking for a good book coach, Kelly Epperson, you can't go wrong. With her because she's just fantastic on helping me with the whole process. And the whole book is about making a choice to, you know, get past the crap in your life. And we all have a lot of crap that we deal with. I'm going to give you a little backstory on the book. It was Easter morning this year. My mom was up. I was up at 5 o'clock in the morning. We were going to go to sunrise service. First cup of coffee went down really good. Second cup of coffee, well, that's when all hell broke loose. I started sweating uncontrollably and shaking. It felt like somebody had like this flaming hot sword that they were running through my midsection. It just like it was such an excruciating pain, nothing like I'd ever felt in my entire life. I actually thought that I was dying. We get to the emergency room. They run their tests. 8 hours later, I wake up only to find I've got a 10-inch incision in my midsection and an ostomy bag on my side, which I'm going to tell you that for those of you that don't know what an ostomy is, I'll tell you an ostomy is when they took for me, they took like a foot out of my intestine and put a little bag on the side, and that collects your it collects your crap. It's kind of like, well, literally really a shitty experience. But and I'm luckier than most because I got to have mine reversed, which a lot of people live their entire lives like that. And you know, it's a different kind of lifestyle, and they do well. They're active, but I digress. So I had this for, you know, 4 months. Went through all the trials and tribulations with it, and I still have some bags left, which I think now that I'm just gonna still put them on my abdomen, but I'm gonna put M&Ms in them, and they'll just be like a little candy dispenser just to freak my granddaughter out. But so in July, my lovely wife and I were in at a festival up in Milwaukee. It was Bastille Days, and what's interesting about Milwaukee, well, actually Wisconsin in general, it's like the land of festivals. Every summer, every weekend during the summer, there's some kind of different festival you can go to. Any excuse really to, you know, to drink and listen to live music. And what's interesting also about Bastille Days is that Milwaukee does not have like a huge French population, but like I said, it is our state pastime drinking. So we're there all day long, enjoying ourselves, listening to music. And at the end of the day, we were getting ready to leave, and they had this table full of people that were doing tarot card readings, and I thought, you know, hey, let's do that. You know, just something just kind of fun to round out the day. I don't put a lot of, you know, credence into what they say. So I sat down with the tarot card reader, and she's like, "All right, put your hands on the card and, you know, think of a question." So I thought of a question, and then I hand her back the card. She's like, "Well, what was your question?" I kind of thought, "Well, shouldn't you know what the question is?" But so I said, "Big question is, what's my big idea?" You know, everybody's got a big idea. You see things and you're like, why didn't I think about that? It's so simple. So she lays the cards out, bam, bam, bam. And she says, well, what I see here is, you know, all the things you've gone through in your life, helping people to get past the crap that they're going through. And I thought, oh, that's the big idea right there, get past the crap. So as soon as we got done, I went on GoDaddy to see if any of the domain names were there, and all of them were available. So I bought them all. Get past the crap, getting past the crap, get past your crap. I bought them all. And I thought, either this is sheer genius or the dumbest idea on the face of the earth, Lutz, because I always refer to myself in the third person. And I always, when it's my own idea, opt on the side of genius. So starting in August, I started, you know, writing the book, you know, because I started thinking about, you know, all the crap I've gone through in my life and all the crap that, you know, other people, they similarly have gone through in their lives, whether it's health issues or it's relationship issues or, you know, family issues. You know, we are a whole people. And we come to work, we bring our whole self. And as leaders, it's hard to lead other people if we're not leading ourselves first. If we don't have some kind of strategy, you know, how to get past that crap, how to power through, how to make a choice to do something a little bit different. So like I said, I'm really excited about the new book. I'm not telling you have to buy it. I think that you probably should because it's awesome. But be looking for it, January 16th. And I'll see you later online.